The next topic is structure of ovule or megasporangium. Ovule is also called as megasporangium and is protected by one or two coverings called integuments. So this is the structure of ovule, and the ovules are protected by outer integument and inner integument. So the protective wall layers which are covering the ovules, the body of the ovule, are called integuments, outer integuments and inner integument. The stalk of the ovule, which is called as funiculus, it is also called as funicle. The stalk of the ovule, which is called as funicle, which attaches the ovule with the placenta and the ovary wall. So from this region, this funicle region only, the ovule is attached with the ovary wall on the placenta. The point of attachment of funicle to the body is known as hilum. So the hilum, funicle, where it is attached with the body of the ovule is known as hilum. This depressed area where the funicle is attached with the ovule is called hilum. Then the space which is left by the outer and inner integument is called as micropyle. And this hilum, which is making a ridged surface on the seed, is called as raphe. So in dicot seeds, we can find a white semicircular structure, which is called as raphe, which is formed by this funicle. Because of the presence of the funicle only, above the dicot seed, we are looking at some white color semicircle structures. That area is called as raphe. The body of the ovule is made up of central mass of parenchymatous tissue called as mucellus. Then in the body of the ovule, so far we have seen about the stalk and the main body of the ovule, it has a mucellus, which is looking like a bag, and it is contains parenchymatous tissue. So homogeneous parenchymatous tissue, which is called as mucellus, and this mucellus, which surrounds the embryo sac, which is located at the center. This embryo sac, which contains 8 nuclei, and it is considered as 7-celled stage. The basal part of the embryo sac, 3 cells are located among the 3. The center one is called as egg cell, and 2 lateral cells are called as synergids. At the center of the embryo sac, 2 cells are present, which are fused together. They are called as secondary nucleus, 2 nucleus, and it is considered as a single cell. And at the upper end also, 3 cells are located, which are called as antipodal cells. So 3 cells, which contains 3 nuclei. At the center, 1 cell, because it is a fused cell, but there are 2 nuclei. At the lower end also, 3 cells. So 3 plus 3 plus 1. At the 7-celled stage, the ovule is angiospermic ovule is available, but the nuclei condition is 8 nucleate. Here 3 nuclei and the egg apparatus. At the upper end, 3 nuclei on the antipodal cells. At the center, secondary nucleus. So 3 plus 3 plus 2 is considered as 8 nucleates stage. The ovules are classified into 2 types, such as unitegmic and bitegmic. Based on the number of the integuments, it is classified as unitegmic and bitegmic. When the ovule contains single integument or the protective wall, which is called as unitegmic ovule. When it possesses 2 integuments, it is known as bitegmic ovule. Based on the position of the sporogenous cells also, ovules are classified into 2 types, which are tuninucellate ovule and crassinucellate ovule. In tuninucellate ovule, the number of hypodermal cells are single layer. There is a single layer of hypodermal cells, which are making a nucellus region. So If the sporogenous cell is hypodermal with a single layer of mucellar tissue, it is known as tuniucellate ovule. So here usually the nucellus will be smaller in size because there is a single layer of nucellus tissue. And the second one is crassi nucellate type. Here some subhypodermal cells, also hypodermal cells, and in addition to hypodermal cells, two or more layers of hypodermal cells, also subhypodermal cells, also involving in the formation of the nucellus. So the nucellus will be larger and it may have more layers of cells. So this type of nucellate is called as crassi nucellate. This can be asked in differentiation question, tuniucellate, how it differs from crassi nucellate. The group of cells found at the base of the ovule between the chalaza and the embryo sac is called a hypostase. So the cells, hypodermal cells, which are located between the chalaza. Chalaza means, you know, it is a opposite end of the micropyle in which integuments, nucellus and funicle are merged together. In the chalaza, below the chalaza, what are the hypodermal cells are present, which are called a hypostase. Likewise, the group of cells which are located above the micropylar end is known as epistase. Next topic is types of ovules. Ovules are classified into six main types based on the orientation, form and position of the micropyle with respect to the funicle and the chalaza. So how the important structures of the ovules are arranged on the ovule, for example, micropyle, chalaza and funicle, how it is arranged and how the orientation takes place on the ovule. Based on these features, ovules are divided into six main types, that are orthotropous ovule, anatropous ovule, hemianatropous ovule and campylotropous ovule. The first one is called orthotropous ovule. In orthotropous ovule, micropyle and the chalaza and the funicle, all these important parts are located in a straight line, straight vertical line. So this is a inverted ovule in which funicle, chalaza and micropyle are located in a straight line. So this type of orthotropous ovule occurs in Piperaceae family and the Polygonaceae family. The second one is called anatropous ovule. When 180 degree rotation takes place in this ovule, it is forming a inverted ovule to the orthotropous, which is called anatropous ovule. The body of the ovule becomes completely inverted so that the micropyle and funiculus comes closer. So funicle, micropyle are located very closer in this anatropous type of ovule. This type of ovule is common in dicots and monocots. Next type of ovule is hemianatropous ovule. In anatropous ovule, 180 degree rotation takes place, we have seen. So hemi means half, we know. So from 180 degree, it takes half rotation or orientation. So from the funicle, the micropyle at the chalaza, it is located right angles, that is 90 degree, half from the anatropous ovule. In anatropous ovule, 180 degree rotation. So here half or semi, so 90 degree rotation takes place from the anatropous ovule. So it is called as hemi anatropous ovule. So in which the body of the ovule is placed transversely, micropyle, chalaza, nucellus, everything is located in the transverse manner and it is right angles to the funicle. This is present in Primulaceae family. And the next one is campylotropous ovule. Here the body of the ovule at the micropylar end is curved. The body of the ovule is curved and more or less it resembles the bean shape. The embryo also slightly curved. All the three, hilum, micropyla, and chalaza, are adjacent to one another. So, funicle, micropyle, and chalaza are more or less adjacent to one another. This type of ovule is present in leguminosae family. So, all pulses varieties contain Campylotropous ovule. The next one is Amphitropous ovule. In Amphitropous ovule, the embryo sac or nucellus, which resembles like a horse shoe shaped structure. So it was much curved and it is looking like a horse shoe shaped structure. And the distance between the hilum and chalaza is very less. This is the hilum and the distance between the chalaza and hilum is very, very less compared with the other ovules. This type of ovule is present in some Alismataceae family. And the last one is the Cynotropous ovule. Here the funicle is very, very lengthy and long and it surrounds the other parts of the ovule. The body of the ovule is much coiled, like a mosquito coil, which is making many circles or the coils around the body of the ovule. So this is called a Cystinotropous ovule. The funicle is very, very long and it surrounds the ovule. This is present in the Cactaceae family.